Welcome, fans, to the second edition of The Blitz, our weekly UConn football show. Today, senior captain Nick Williams will be joining us to talk about our 37-0 victory over UMass in the season opener, and redshirt senior captain Jory Johnson will be here to talk about our battle against NC State of the ACC. This week on Coach's Corner, you'll get to hear from head coach Paul Pasqualoni as he answers questions from you, the fans, and special teams coordinator and running backs coach Clayton White will be joining us as well. So thanks for tuning in, and now, The Blitz. Welcome, Husky fans, to Coach's Corner. I am joined now by head coach Paul Pasqualoni. Thanks for being here today.
Well, it's nice to be here.
Now, before we get into fan questions, can you take us back to the victory over UMass, what you saw that you liked, and how that will translate to NC State?
Well, I thought it was a good start to the season. There's clearly things that we have to do better. We have to run the ball better. We have to take care of the ball better. We turned it over three times in that game. And if we do that against NC State, we're not going to have the same results that we had against UMass. But I thought there were many things we did well. I thought there was excellent effort. I thought we played with intensity, focus, and effort. I thought special teams were very, very good all the way around. And I thought, obviously, defensively, we responded and played a very, very good football game. So it was a good start. We need to have a really good afternoon against NC State. Play smart, take care of the ball, and not give up big plays, and we'll have a chance to have a very good game.
Great. Well, after such an exciting season opener, we have plenty of fans with questions for you, so you ready to take them on?
Well, I don't know, but we'll try.
All right, let's take a look.
Hi, I'm Zach from Rehoboth, Massachusetts, and I was wondering, after a 37-0 shutout victory, how do you feel about your defense going into next week?
Well, Zach, we feel good about the defense. We're hopeful that we'll be able to continue to do a great job against the run, and more importantly, or equally as important, we didn't give up any big plays on defense against UMass, and that was a really big factor in the game. So our goal this week will be to stop the run and then not give up big passes to NC State's outstanding wide receivers.
All right, great. Let's take a look at the next one.
My name is Shalomi Davidi. I'm from New Haven, Connecticut. UConn versus UMass was my first football game, and I had a great time. I was wondering what your favorite thing is about the atmosphere at the field.
Shalomi, my favorite thing about the atmosphere at UConn football and basketball games is the student section. I think that the energy that you guys bring really helps us, and the noise and the amount of fun that you guys appear to be having really is very helpful.
We definitely have a lot of Husky pride out there. All right, let's take a look at the last question.
Hi, I'm Sarah, and I'm here with Annie and Kelly. And we were just wondering, when you're not coaching, what do you do in your free time?
Sarah, in my free time, I have a 13-year-old, a 12-year-old, and a 10-year-old. So every ounce of my free time is with my wife and my three kids, and we have a lot of fun together.
Well, perfect. I know our fans are really excited to hear from you each and every week, so thanks so much for joining us on our segment.
Thank you.
All right, Husky fans, be sure to be on the lookout for the Huskies All-Access crew on campus, at games, and at our tailgates to have your questions submitted so Coach P can answer your questions here on Coach's Corner. We are joined now by special teams coordinator and running backs coach Clayton White. Thanks for being here with us today.
Thank you very much.
Now, we obviously had to have you on for NC State, your alma mater, a place where you were a three-year starting linebacker in the record books three times over for tackles for loss, for career, single game, and single season. It seems like you enjoyed spending time on the other side of the line of scrimmage.
Absolutely. I mean, I grew up, actually, I was a high school quarterback, but then now, you know, I got to NC State, and they changed me up and told me I need to be a defensive player. So I enjoyed it, had fun.
So now, obviously, NC State is a special place for you. What are your emotions coming into this game now that you're a Husky?
I know when I first saw the schedule, the first thing I thought was like, wow, I can't believe we're actually playing NC State. You got to understand, I'm from North Carolina, born and raised, and it's only a couple of schools that you can really decide that you want to go to, and Wolfpack was the school that I, since I was 8 years old, I wanted to go to be a Wolfpack. So, I mean, obviously we understand that that's where I went to school, and it's going to be, it's been a weird week for me, so, but I think everything's going
to
be all right.
So now looking back to the opening game of the season, both your special teams and your running backs had good showing. Mm-hmm. Can you talk about what you saw out of each group that you liked?
Well, I mean, from a special team standpoint, I thought what I liked the most was that the guys believed, and they all understood that, you know, it takes, you know, everyone to get a win, basically. So they came out to play, and, you know, they were productive, and they had a good week of practice, and Coach P harps on special teams a lot. So they understand that it takes a great special team showing us in order for us to get a win. And running back-wise, I thought we played three guys, and, you know, Lyle had a productive day. Wish he had a little bit more yards, but for the most part, you know, we got some improving to do, and I think we'll be all right.
And on the special team side, we have to talk about that blocked punt by Taylor
yes.
Mack that Max DiLorenzo
yes.
scooped up. The place went wild. Mm-hmm. You gave us a little fist pump on the uh-huh. sideline. Can you take me through that play?
Well, if you remember the play, it was a flag on the play, number one. I thought we were offsides. I saw the flag early, but UMass kind of tried to quick snap the football, and some of our guys were ready, some of our guys weren't. Obviously, Taylor was ready. Taylor got a great get off, and he went and blocked it, and Deshaun had a chance to have a touchdown, but he decided, him and Max are good friends, so he decided to give the touchdown to Max. So Deshaun said he'd get the next one. So it was pretty. It was very exciting. But I was more worried about the flag. Me and Coach P were like, we can't get a break here tonight. But when he said decline, and, you know, we all kind of got pumped up. We needed that. Our guys needed to see that, so it was fun.
Through the fist pump, much deserved. All right, looking ahead to NC State, how do we go 2-0?
You know, it has to be a team effort again. We have to come out and play football, and, you know, I know our crowd's going to be there. It's going to be a big day, so, you know, offense, defense, especially, need to come together one more time and try to get a win.
Great. Well, thanks so much for joining us here today, Coach. We're happy to have you on the Husky side.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I'm glad to be here, I promise you, so thanks
a lot.
All
right, great. Thank you, Coach.
Yep, thank you.
And now let's take a look back at highlights from our victory over UMass.
Offset eye in the backfield, play action, toss out to Olszewski. He's got it up the right side of the UMass territory, and he swung down from behind at the 37-yard line. Drops back, looks, lobs a pass wide open to Williams on the left flat. 15, 10 to the 5. Now Nick Williams comes in motion left to right. They give it to Nick, tries to turn the corner, stutter steps, cuts it back inside, down to the 1-yard line. Takes it, gives to McCombs, goes into the end zone, touchdown, Connecticut. Wobbly spiral to Williams. He feels it at the 36. Stutter steps up to the 40. 45. Into UMass territory. Cuts right. Middle of the field. One man to beat. Denny's dragged out from behind at the 31-yard line. Huskies showing blitz. They don't. Wakes it. Drops back. Pocket collapse. Chased by Smallwood. Sacked by Smallwood. Out of the gun. It's Whitmer. Has time. Looks. Throws out in the flat from the home. He's got it. Breaks a tackle. He's got the first down inside the 30. Spot. Kick is on the way. And the kick is good. Burns goes in motion to the left. They fake the rubble screen and on the reverse. Play action. Whitmer drops back. Looks. Nobody open. No, he throws. He's got to be a complete into UMass territory at the 48-yard line. Good snap. Spot. Line drive. Kick. It's good. Brings it out to the 10, to the 50. No, he's tech-tied, tackled by Reuben Frank. Fullback, strong to the left. Quick count, Whitmer, straight drop. Chandler looks, throws for Davis over the middle. Leaping catch at the 35-yard line. Kick is blocked. There's a flag on the play. It's falling out in the end zone for a touchdown. Split to the left. Direct snap. They give it a Cox, hit behind the line of scrimmage by Smallwood and Joseph. Trips to the left. They roll the pocket that way. Wags and looks. Chased from behind. It's sacked. Trevardo Williams, his first sack of the season, got him from behind. Late blitz. Pass over the middle to Davis at the UMass 45. Pivots to the right. Tries to get around his man. He can't. McCummings lines up as the quarterback. Williams in motion. They give it to Williams. Now they flip it to Whitmer. He looks. He throws downfield for Griffin. It's late. Griffin goes up and makes the catch at the 11. Motion left to right. McCummings keeps it and goes in for a Connecticut touchdown. Everybody in tight. McAtee gives to DiLorenzo. Cuts it to the right. Turns the corner to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown!
Well, there were certainly no shortage of highlights from Thursday night. Joining us now is one of the players who made that happen, senior wide receiver and captain Nick Williams, who was our player of the game on Thursday. He had 143 all-purpose yards. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
Now, the Rent was an exciting place to be on Thursday night. You talked after the game about how this was such a team win for you guys. So let's get right into it, starting with the offense. Chandler threw for 219 yards. We saw production out of 8 different receivers. We ran for just under 150 yards. Can you talk about the various ways that you guys attacked that UMass defense?
Yeah, I think Chandler played a great game considering it was his first game. He had a lot of pressure on him. The new quarterback and his leadership skills showed through the game. He was precise. He was accurate. He was confident on the sideline, and it just shows how much hard work he puts in during the week. He's the first guy in the film room, the last one out of it, and that showed on Thursday night.
Now we have to talk about the play that everyone has been talking about. Scott McCummings takes the snap, hands it off to you. You flip it to Chandler. He launches a 34-yard pass to Ryan Griffin. Was that play as much fun for you guys to run as it was for us to watch it?
Yeah, anytime we practice a trick play during the week and then it gets called during the game, everybody gets a little excited knowing what's about to unfold. But yeah, that's a pretty crazy play that Coach DeLeon drew up, and we went out there and executed it.
All right, and defensively, the stats are just ridiculous. A shutout, first of all, but they only had 3 first downs. They never took an offensive snap on our side of the ball. 2 sacks, 1 interception. What is it about this defense that allows them to be that productive?
I think Coach Brown's scheme really fits the players that we have. We've got great pass rushers, and we've got great corners. So anytime you have a combination of getting to the quarterback quickly and people who can cover, you're going to have a dominant defense, and they just play great. They're all over the ball. UMass only had 3 first downs. I've never heard of that in a game I've played in or highlights that I've watched. There's just a pretty strong performance by the defense, and hopefully they can build on that coming into this week.
And lastly, a place that you know well, special teams. You had 2 really strong runs. Chad knocked down 3 field goals in his debut in that position, and of course that blocked punt by Taylor Mack that got everyone so excited. We had Coach White on here earlier talking about how fired up he was about it. Can you take us through that play and also just how exciting special teams can be this year?
Yeah, I think Coach White has put a huge investment in special teams, so has Coach Pasqualoni, and I was real happy to see Chad play well, knowing that Taggart left and he had a lot of pressure being the replacement kicker, and he went out there and handled it well. He kicked all 3 field goals, also did a good job kicking off. Taylor Mack had the block punt. That was awesome to see. It was nice. Max DiLorenzo recovered it. That was fun. That's when I'm back there, I'm kind of like a fan on that play, seeing if they get to the block or not. So that was pretty cool. And we had some good returns. Our schemes worked out, and I think the effort in the week shined through in the game.
Well, it was certainly an exciting game for us to all be a part of. Thanks so much for joining us here today. We look forward to seeing you guys against NC State.
Thanks for having me.
All right, now let's take a look ahead now to our next opponent, the Wolfpack of NC State. Now let's welcome to the show redshirt senior linebacker and captain Jory Johnson, who had 3 tackles and a breakup in our victory over UMass. Thanks for being here today.
Thanks for having me. I'm glad to be here.
Next up, we have NC State of the ACC. They are coming off a loss from Tennessee, but we saw some serious production from their offense. Their quarterback, Mike Glennon, threw for 288 yards. They also had 2 rushing touchdowns. What are the keys in shutting down a productive offense like that?
Most importantly, I think we have to be lined up properly, execute. We have to do what we do, and that's blitz, cover guys, make sure we're not cutting anybody loose down the field, because they do have a great offense. They have a great offensive line, very experienced. Mike Gannon's a great quarterback, and they have a quarterback that can get the ball to at any time. So most importantly is we have to execute the calls to a tee, basically, and get lined up and be ready for anything.
NC State gave up 22 points in the first quarter to Tennessee. We were up 20 at the half against UMass. How does it affect the defense having the offense get on the board so early?
It really helps us play a lot looser. Playing with the lead, it gives us a lot more option to take a lot more chances, to blitz more, to do a lot of different things that we do, so it does help playing with the lead.
Now, you came out of the gates running against UMass, a very exciting game. How do you take the motivation from winning game number one to propel us into game number two?
Just come out and start fast like we did last week. We're going to be at home. We're going to have the home crowd behind us, so I think that's a big advantage to have. So we're just going to come out, hopefully start fast like we did last time. I think starting out on defense really helped because we were able to go three and out, and it just kept the momentum. We got a big return. So we just need plays like that to start fast, because I think it was one thing Tennessee did do against NC State, and they were able to hold that throughout the game. So even though NC State was able to battle back a little bit, they were so behind early. So I think when we get on them early, it helps throughout the game, and then we're going to be at home, so that's another advantage for us.
Well, I know we all are really excited to see the Huskies take on the Wolfpack. Thanks so much for joining us here today.
All right, thanks for having me. I'm excited.
All right, next up, the Huskies take on NC State Saturday, September 8th at Rentschler Field at noon. You can catch the game on SNY or on WTIC News Talk 1080. But if you can, we'd love to have you come down to Rentschler Field. The game will be a blowout, so we want you to rock your Husky pride and show up at Rentschler Field. Thanks for tuning in to The Blitz. I'm Emily Noonan for Huskies All Access. See you out there.